the task force made a recommendation that PSA testing is not worthwhile in individuals because screening doesn't help prevent and save lives. And this is the same group that made the recommendations about mammograms in women age 40 and above about not doing mammograms and screening individuals for breast cancer. The argument for the task force is that they've made these recommendations because they feel that once patients get diagnosed with prostate cancer, that many of these individuals that may have indolent disease end up getting treated or they get worried about the disease. We as urologists, on the other hand, feel that it's important to make all the recommendations known and have patients understand their disease, and then they can make a decision based on full disclosure, if you will. So for example, the PSA test, it's a blood test. It's not a treatment. Number two, the task force used screening data that really had multiple flaws in it. Two large studies were used in that for that recommendation. The first is a European study that was done that showed indeed at 11 years, there's about a 20% reduction in the mortality in men that are screened for prostate cancer. The second study was the prostate, ovarian, lung, and the placo study. And in this study, what it showed is that there was no benefit to survival in individuals that were screened. Now, there's some problems in the placo study because there were two groups of patients that were screened for prostate cancer compared to groups that weren't screened for prostate cancer, and they found no difference. The problem is almost half of the patients that weren't supposed to be screened for prostate cancer actually had a PSA blood test done and are contaminated. So the recommendations were based on flawed data. These studies are not, you know, and the studies have flaws in them, and they were essentially used to determine and make this recommendation. So I think that we have to put it in perspective. I think patients have a right to understand their diseases that they have and possible treatments. Now, there's no question that a lot of these cancers don't need to be treated, but I think giving patients information is a very useful and I think a very useful tool that can help patients understand their condition and then let them make an informed decision.